Gunnar, Matthew. Now, you could have done that like a year ago, and they would have just clapped and said, you know, that's really nice and everything.
So. You have too many guys in the audience, I think.
Oh, please. I feel a little bloated, but I think...
I think it looks good after the holidays.
I think, well, yeah, I really do, actually. I put on a couple pounds, actually. I'm up to 108.
How much do you weigh? How much do you weigh?
Oh, I don't know. About 135?
No, 140. You weigh 140.
You both weigh the same?
No, I weigh about 134. I've always been a little bit.
Yeah.
I know, it's the string bean weight.
Well, Lisa's been putting this drink together for me. Uh-huh. That, you know, because...
Hi, Lisa.
Hey.
Woo!
This is... Everybody's
to help
drinking...
help you out a little bit.
Okay.
You can still dance, though. You can feel good about that.
I This is Mr. Cool. Diet. You've seen it on everything. So I'm just going to kind of sip this as we get into this interview.
Oh, okay. Mm. I think it looks good on you. I think it does. Yeah, I think you needed to fill
just out. Just a couple of pounds, you know.
Yeah.
You
it's a holiday thing.
Well, you get the holiday thing. You get bulked up and everything. Mm-hmm. This is like Mr. Diet. Have you seen this advertised on TV? It's unbelievable.
It tastes like chalk, doesn't it?
It tastes just like chalk. Look at these boots. Wow, Matthew.
See, you can tell the difference. Gunnar has no manners.
Yeah.
No. It's okay. I put my feet up there and
did a lot of that over the holidays, huh?
What is that?
Woo! The fire engine beige, man.
I just feel bloated as hell.
Cool. So 30% more days to boost. Like
I got so many questions for you guys. First of all,
okay.
This whole deal about you and women, both of you. I mean, it's like one after another. You're not into drugs, obviously.
No.
You're not into other things, but not into gambling. But you've just got a real thing. It's like it's just like one chick after another.
Yeah, it's a refreshing thing, especially in Los Angeles, man. You know, it is. It's a healthy thing. You know, we're 23 years old, and it's a lot of fun. You know, we get to do all the stupid twin pranks and all that. But,
Have you ever, was there ever a line like,
well, the only one is, you know, I think we talked about on your radio show that the line that never fails is, have you ever had twins, you know?
Oh, no!
Well, guys know this one, okay?
Hey, look, okay, you see her
in a bar.
Right, you see her in a bar, and you try every come on line that you have, and you're really going down in flames, you know? And really, to save face, you gotta pull it out of the hat and stuff.
Right.
Yeah,
we've
only,
yeah, we haven't been turned down yet, but we've only used the line twice, so, you know.
I want to come back and find out if anybody fell for it, okay?
Okay.
We're going to come back, we're going to talk to Nelson some more, they're going to sing for you, and I'm going to continue with Mr. Diet. To see if anything happens, they guarantee to peel the weight off. Stay here in the night.
Into the Night, starring Rick Dees. Brought to you by Edge Shaving Gel. For less irritation, you've got the edge.
That stuff is amazing. I don't know, it feels like I've lost a little bit on
you
this
know,
thing.
Something's changed in you.
It's just amazing.
Couple of minutes.
What was it, Mr. Diet? You got to try that stuff. Then you drink, of course, 12 to 15 glasses of water an hour.
Okay. Doesn't make you very popular in the fine. Day.
Now, do you guys wash or set your hair?
Wash or set our hair?
I mean, that's a natural
People
question.
Normally wash their hair.
I know you wash it. It looks clean. It looks great. I mean, I'm serious, but it is clean, I'm sure, but I mean...
Rick, what are you trying to say?
I'm trying to say, I have a natural question about this. How long does it take? Do you blow dry it or do you let it dry naturally?
Maybe.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
No, he's the only person that's not blonde on this couch. This particular time.
I think we were voted in a magazine very recently as having the most... What was it?
The most obnoxious hair of the year.
Yeah, most obnoxious hair.
And hey, you know,
it made it win, you know? Look, at least they're talking, you know? That's all
sure.
I can say. But, you know, we don't spray it. We don't mousse it. It's hair, okay? Get over it. It's hair. It's blonde and it's hair. And that's
about 5 minutes, man. In the shower, out of the shower, blow dry, and go.
Tell me about the supposedly the night that you both became men on the same night.
What is so this stuff?
You know what? This is how the night went, okay? This is how the night went. Ready, Gun?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. No, you know, things happen that way with twins, I guess. Maybe it's not just a twin thing. That's kind of cool, though, because, you know, we're always going around together and stuff. When we were in high school, we really were our own best friends. It was like that, and music mm-hmm. was really what got us through.
Did you ever send, like on a blind date, did you ever send Matthew out?
No, there were a couple of occasions when I thought he was really slacking off, and I said, hey, look, you know, if you don't, like, pick up with this girl and give her a call, I think she's really special. Next time I'm going to show up and say I'm you.
And I'd have to hit him instead of me.
Did it ever work? I mean, because, you know, just in a casual meeting,
doesn't anymore. I don't think we really look that similar anymore. You know, I mean,
Matthew,
I used to.
Matthew, you're the oldest by what, 45
minutes? 45 minutes. And that's why he got the name Gunnar, I guess.
Yeah, it was always difficult.
Yeah, who came up, your mom or your dad, with the name Gunnar?
I think it was my dad. Mm-hmm. The Nelson family is a very Swedish name, of course, you know,
If you don't know, I mean, and if you don't know this, obviously, they're from a famous family, Ricky Nelson, tremendous pop superstar.
Oh, that's hot.
And a teen idol in his song. And, of course, Tracy was on the show a couple of weeks ago, did a super job.
She's our hero.
She cursed on your show.
She did. Can you believe that? Yeah. Your sister.
Yeah, blew everybody's image of her just right out of the water.
She called me, she said, are you sure people aren't, are they going to like me still? Trace, it's okay. You can say the F word. You live in Los Angeles.
But she's a nun on TV, you know.
Yeah,
that's a tough thing to do.
Nice, yeah. What a stretch, huh? She's a married lady.
So you are close to your sister, though.
Oh, yeah. She's really been our biggest supporter, our biggest fan. Mm.
She was about to tell me a story, and we didn't get around to it, about your dad and Garden Party, that song.
Uh-huh. Right.
Fill me in. Break that down.
Well, you know, that really does relate into to just what our whole attitude has really worked out to be. It's really a positive sort of thing. That's what we want to get out there. My dad, his whole life, the one thing he didn't do was play Madison Square Garden, and he really wanted to play it, and he was finally invited to, I think it was the early 60s, like,
No. It was later on. It was a rock and roll revival, I think, in 1969.
That's mm-hmm. right.
And he had his new band, the Stone Canyon Band, and he threw his hair out, and he was playing his songs that he wrote, which, you know, in the days of Elvis and my dad and stuff like that, in the 50s, nobody wrote their own material. And then when the Beatles came in with Bob Dylan and stuff, he really went through kind of a personal and cultural renaissance, really.
He was doing something. He was noticed for pioneering what they called the California Sound. It was before the Eagles and stuff. But there was, you know, country vocals over rock tracks.
And he went out to do a show, and it was supposed to be a revival. And everybody else was dressed in kind of, you know, poodle skirts and that kind of thing. And he came out with long hair and looking very contemporary and played a couple of versions of his songs from the 50s, but rock and roll, you know, something that was contemporary. Mm-hmm. And he was booed off the stage for doing something that he really felt was right. And it was the first time, you know, a pop had really gone through life being accepted unconditionally, really. And he'd never really known what it was like to feel that way. And so what he did was, he went home absolutely crushed and sat down one night, and Tracy was listening on the floor, and he was playing his piano. His piano room was downstairs. And he stayed up all night long. And when he came up in the morning, she said, what were you working on, Pop? And he said, it's a song, I just wrote it last night, it's called Garden Party. And he took out a piece of paper that he didn't want to even get up, and he wrote all over this one piece of paper, and the song went to number 6 in the Billboard charts, and he said he would have traded all of his, you know, the number one successes and stuff, because it was a piece of him, and
it was part of the song.
It really is.
Yeah, one of my favorites of his, because he really did take that incredibly negative situation. He could have gone home, totally blown his vibe and stuff, and he just turned it right around, and it was great.
He'd be so proud of both of you. He really would be.
We're coming back to sing next. Nelson, stay up.
Just looking over this, this is almost like a dinosaur, you know, to have an album. Because everybody's getting CDs and cassettes these days, but you can still get an album. The band is Nelson, and they are hot. This is After the Rain. Thank you.
By now you should know. You're living in a fantasy, but you can't escape.
Information Society, they're so good. And these people have just torn up the audience tonight. Matthew and Gunnar Nelson, back more than ever.
Thank you.
to say. I got something I want to say. You know, even though I may not think to tell you this,
that's smoking, man. That's smoking.